Hello and welcome. In this video, I'm going to show how to set up a Xorcom CompletePBX system from scratch to working phones and extensions. We're going to do three simple steps. Step one would be to create or bulk import the extensions. Step two, to modify and set up the phone templates if necessary. And step three, using the PhoneScan mobile app, we're going to assign the phones to the right templates and extensions. We have three IP phones here, Yalink, Fanville, and Xorcom. Three IP phones, three vendors. It can be three, it can be 300. The process is the same. It's quick, easy, and simple. Let's start. The first thing we need to do is to configure our extensions. There are two ways to do that. One is manual. We can simply go to PBX Extensions, Extensions, and set up the extensions manually. The minimum we'll have to do is to just type the extension number and a name, and that's it. The other way is to use import extensions. In order to do that, we'll first go to export extensions. We will export the template file and we'll use it to create a file to import with all the extensions and their information. This is a file I prepared with over 270 extensions with all the details, and we will use this file. So I'll just go to import extensions, select the proper file, and hit import. Now the system will create all my extensions. I will see a log confirming it, and I'll have to apply. Okay, so import was completed successfully. I can see all the extensions that were created here and devices. I will hit refresh or apply. And once it's done, I will be able to see all the extensions in the system. Okay, the one I created manually and the 270 I created by import extensions. The second step will be to create or edit templates. Templates define the IP phone parameters, and they're found here under Settings, Endpoint Manager, Templates. For every supported model, there is already a default template ready. So we can use the default template, we can edit the default template, or we can create a whole new template. So for now, let's just edit one of the default templates for the Yalink phone. Say we add two BLF keys here. And update the template. Apply, and now we have basically set up the server side. The next step will be to go to the phones and using the PhoneScan app to assign the phones to an extension and make them use a certain template. In order to start working with PhoneScan, we need to allow connection from the PBX side. In order to do that, we will go to Settings, Endpoint Manager, PhoneScan, and we'll get this dialog. If we don't get it, it's probably because PhoneScan is not licensed. You need to get a license and apply it. What we see here now is that PhoneScan is disabled. Let's enable it, and two things are happening. One, we see the QR code here, and we have a timer. Basically, this is countdown until the connection shuts down for security reasons, so that we won't forget it open. And the QR code allows us to connect the PhoneScan app on our mobile phone to the PBX. If we don't have enough time, we need more time than those 30 minutes, we just need to hit reset and we get 30 minutes from that point. The next thing we'll need to do is to get our mobile phone and, using the PhoneScan app, scan the QR code. So we'll go ahead and open the PhoneScan mobile app. And we're asked to scan the PBX QR code, so we'll go ahead and scan it right off the screen. And as you can see, we're connected to this IP address. If the PBX will have a name rather than IP address, we'll see the name here. And we are ready to scan the phones. So let's start with the Xorcom phone. We'll find the label with the MAC ID and just scan it. Okay, we see it's the right MAC ID. We'll hit next. We need to select template. You see it already recognizes the vendor. We'll choose the right model. If I scan another one from the same vendor, it will offer me the same vendor by default. Let's find the device. We'll search actually for the extension. We can also do that. And we see Dr. Mike, extension 2000. Device name is also Dr. Mike because it was auto-generated with that name. And we will assign that and go ahead to the next phone. Fanville. And we'll go ahead and scan the MAC ID. Hit next. Pick the right template. And we'll assign it to extension 2001. Sign, next phone, the Yalink phone, and we will assign this one, to another extension. As you may remember, we set up speed dial here, or BLF keys rather. Here it is. And we're done. We don't want to assign any more phones. So we confirm. We just shut down the connection. Now we can go ahead and boot up the phones, connect them to the network. The phones will find the PBX on the network and get their configuration. It may take a minute or two to boot up, and they may reboot again during the process, but in the end they'll get the configuration we set up. As you can see, now we have three phones up and running, each got their configuration. We have 2000, 2001, 2002. We have the BLF keys that we set in the template. We manually set it. So let's try to go ahead and call Dr. Mike. Okay, and we see this phone is ringing. We can make calls. We see caller ID. Everything is up and running. Now we only need to connect a trunk and we have a functional PBX. So that was PBX setup in three simple steps: create extensions, modify templates, assign the extension using the mobile app, and we're done. Thank you very much.